questions in clinical data management that are these are the most we'll be adding more questions in data management, clinical research and pharmacovigilance, but we'll start with the basic questions. So the most logical question that comes into anybody's mind is, what is clinical data management? Data management in clinical research relates to the processes of gathering, capturing, monitoring, analysis, and reporting on data. Data management begins with the development of data management plan, design of the data capture instrument, example, the case report form, data collection and regular quality control procedures, database cleaning, locking, analysis, and archiving and write-up. So data flow in clinical trial and clinical data management stages, the protocol design happens and the data management plan, CRF design, database design, data capture, data validation, data lock, statistical analysis, reporting, and then publication. The involved personals in the clinical data management process is the data manager, database designer, data entry associate, medical coder, quality control associate. Now, what is a data management plan? The data management plan is a very important piece of study documentation. Depending on the study, the plan may be made up of several documents. It should give a complete picture on how the data will be handled throughout the study by outlining all the information related to the study data management process procedures. So data management plan is created during project planning, updated during, like any document, it will be updated as per the study. So during the project conduct, documenting the data during post-publication data sharing and archival. The next is the case report form, the CRF. A CRF, also known as data collection form, data collection instrument, turns the protocol into the data capture system. So in basic terms, whatever data needs to be collected in the protocol is done through CRF to cover all the points. The CRF is essential in obtaining accurate and complete study data. The 1996 International Council on Harmonization Principles of GCP, Good Clinical Practice Guidelines, defines a CRF as a printed, optical, and electronic document that is designed to record all of the protocol required information to be reported to the sponsor on each study subject. The CRF design should run parallel to the protocol development. Please note, the full form of ICH is International Council on Harmonization. Earlier on was International Conference. Now it's Council, so we'll stick to that. This is an example of how a CRF looks like. It's a paper-based one. You can see the format of the date of birth is given, the gender, you have to take, the height has to be in centimeters, the weight has to be in kgs. So this is how one of the sections, like a demography section of a CRF looks like. Next important definition is ICH, the International Council of Harmonization for Technical Requirements for Registration of Pharmaceutical for Human Use. ICH began in 1990 as an effort to standardize pharmaceutical regulatory requirement in Europe, Japan, and the US. The ultimate objective of ICH are to maintain safety and quality while increasing efficiencies in the use of human, animal, and material resources, and help eliminate unnecessary delays in bringing new medical treatment to market. Another important term is CDISC, C-D-I-S-C, Clinical Data Interchange Standard Consortium. We have another video on that. I'll put a link on it in the end of the session, so you can also go through that. CDISC Foundation standards are the basics for complete suite of the standards supporting clinical and non-clinical research processes from end to end. Foundation standards focus on the core principles for defining data standards, including models, domains, specifications for data representation. CIRIC's data exchange standards facilitates the sharing of structured data across different information and systems. There are various CIRIC standards like clinical data acquisition standard harmonization, laboratory model lab is there, operation data model ODM, data study data tabulation models SDTM, analysis database model, data set model, sorry, ADAMS. So they have a different role in different study, like during the planning, the protocol study design, data collection, CIRAX is there, and data tabulation, CDTM is there, SEND is there, data analysis, ADAM is there, data archival and exchange is the operational data model is there. So these are standards on how to capture data and make it more uniform. Another is clinical data management practices. It is released by Society for Clinical Data Management. The good clinical data management practice standards provide a reference to the clinical data managers in the implementation of high quality clinical trial, clinical data management processes, and is used as a guiding tool for clinical data managers when preparing the CDM training and education. Another document that is there is the standard operating procedure, SOP. We have to keep in mind the data management plan and the protocol are study specific. SOP is the organization specific. So it will be organization specific, the place, suppose you're working on a site in clinical research, they have their own SOP on how to do clinical research, or maybe you're working in a CRO or a pharma company, they'll have their own SOPs. Irrespective of clinical research or data management, SOPs are in all domains of work profiles. So standard procedures, but they do appear under a variety of names, standard operating procedure, the most being common, departmental operating procedures, guidelines, working practice documents, company user manual, and so on. While the philosophy behind the way these documents are written and maintained might be different, an auditor could ask them to all to understand how the tasks are carried out and would expect them that all the standard operating procedures be adhered to. You have to follow the SOP. Structured guideline documents detail a series of steps for achieving an expected outcome. Describe technical and fundamental operational elements are a set of written instructions for routine activities followed by research site or the clinical data management department are important way to help you follow the good clinical practice, that is GCP. Another term is UAT, user acceptance testing. As the name suggests, user acceptance testing is a critical component in the clinical trial process. Its primary goal is to ensure that the electronic data capture system fulfills the requirement for a study. UAT is an element of the examination and documentation. UAT results serve as one component of objective evidence supporting the validation process. UAT is performed by users of the database or CDMS and should test for both false positive, false negative results in all fields and functions. UAT characteristics occurs after development and quality assurance, but before production. Business or client testers evaluate the product against its requirement, catch bug at the last opportunity before they run in production, ensure that developers and QA delivers a viable product. Data capture, the term data capture refers to the accumulation of the clinical data onto the database in a consistent logical fashion so that it can be retrieved and researched and searched. The content of the database should be the exact representation of the investigator's observation at the clinical trial site, and capture of data must not obstruct this. Now, when the data is captured on a software, then it's called electronic data capture. EDC system is software that stores patient details carried in clinical trial. data is typically first recorded on paper and then transcribed into the system and saved in an electronic case report form, ECRF. Sponsor contract research organization and sites have adopted EDC systems to carry out both the simple and complex trials in a phase of research. An electronic data capture system is a computerized system designed for the collection of clinical data in an electronic format for use mainly in human clinical trials. So typically EDC provides a graphical user interface component for data entry, a validation component to check user data, a reporting tool for analysis of the collected data. EDC systems are used by life science organizations defined as pharmaceutical, medical device, biotechnological industry, and all aspects of clinical research, but are particularly beneficial for the late phase studies and pharmacovigilance and post-marketing, so post-market safety surveillance. Data privacy. It refers to the standards surrounding protection of personal data. Personal data can be defined as an information that can lead to identification either direct or indirectly of a research subject. Some examples of personal data are subject's name, initials, address, and genetic information. We know subject name is not mentioned in most of the documents in clinical research. To protect their privacy and confidentiality. Another term is OCR, Optical Character Recognition Technology, is a business solution for automating data extraction from printed or written text from a scanned document or an image file and then convert it into the text into the machine readable form to be used for data processing like editing and searching. So anything, any image the OCR captures will be converted into text. Discrepancies can another data discrepancies we are referring to. We also have a video on that as well. I'll share that link as well to you. Discrepancies come from several sources: manual review of data and CRF by clinical or data management, computerized check of data by data management system or entry application, computerized check or analysis by data management or biostatistics using external systems. So data validation discrepancies, data clarification form can, you know, you can manually or by paper as well as electronically. If you have any discrepancy in the data that is entered, the data clarification form comes. If yes, then the investigator, it goes to the investigator or the concerned person and the resolution is there. And it is, then it's entered into the database. If the discrepancy doesn't require data clarification, then it can you can go to the CRA bodies like MSSO or APSLA in order to provide a statistically quantifiable count of all similar terms in a given database. It is performed to facilitate summarizing and analysis of certain set of data, like adverse events, medical history records, concomitant medication, etc. To provide control and consistency, a variety of medical coding dictionaries may be used to analyze and report collected data. Extraction of coded data from clinical database and installing data in the in-house coding platform, auto coding can occur by computers. Manual coding, that can't be auto coded. Query entry and query resolutions of terms in collaboration with clinical trial sites and data management. Extraction of the coding list by Mayo metrics units and review of the coding list. Preparation of coding reports for submission to study sponsor. SC reconciliation. So what happens? SCs are critical data, right? So SAEs are serious adverse events like hospitalization, life-threatening, death, congenital anomaly. So the data on all serious adverse events that occur during a clinical trial are recorded in two databases, clinical database that is maintained by the clinical data management and the master drug safety database by the safety team. So clinical database is created and maintained by the clinical data management team. Master safety database is the database maintained by the sponsor. So reconciliation is performed to ensure the event recorded in the SAE database and those residing in the clinical database are consistent. We have to check both the database so that the SAE is entered in one database, like a clinical database, is the same as the one that is being entered by the sponsor. So the SAE reconciliation process compare the data between the two software, review discrepancies, resolve discrepancies, update data, review SAE relevant data from the safety and the clinical data and compare them, hold an SAE reconciliation meeting to discuss the discrepant data, SAE missing, generate query, SAE related data point is inconsistent, generate a query, referred term is inconsistent, discuss with the study responsible physician, and then you can update it. Like adverse event in safety database meets serious criteria, ask to submit the SAE data in ECRF. There are many ways on which you can resolve this. Ask data safety to update database ASAP. Ask the site to report SAE immediately. Ask site to update ECRF, site response to query. Ask site to repair data points immediately. Communicate inconsistent data for upgrade to the safety database. Update the safety or the clinical database. Document all decision and action. That's the most important part. Okay, we have come to the end. For any diploma course or webinar related query, do visit our website, that is www.finessinstitute.com, or email, you can obviously contact admin@finessinstitute.com. Please do like us on Facebook and subscribe to our YouTube channel for more such content and information related to new articles or job openings, that is also available on Facebook as well as LinkedIn. Thank you.